Good morning, all of you. And we know that British literature is broadly divided into three periods. Starting with the Old English period or the Anglo-Saxon period, starting from 600 AD to 1100 AD. And it was in 1066 the Norman invasion took place. And it is this reason why the Middle English period begins from 1100 AD. There is also another reason. Geoffrey of Monmouth, the author of the Historia Regum Britannia, was born in 1100 AD. And his book actually speaks about the origin of British history. And after all, the Middle English period covers the period of Geoffrey Chaucer, Gower, Langland, and a few other writers also, extending up to 1550. And towards the end of the Middle English period, we come to find that there is Renaissance literature promoted by writers like Thomas Mallory, Thomas Moore, William Caxton, and poets like Thomas White and Henry Howard. They are the Renaissance writers. And this is actually the time we discuss Thomas White. It was Thomas White who introduced the sonnet pattern in British literature. And he had occasions to visit Italy, and he learned the sonnet pattern found in Italy and introduced it into English literature. In fact, it solved the problem in British literature. There was chaos at the time. The people didn't actually know how to constitute poetry. And sonnet was a new pattern introduced by Thomas White. And he brought out the Petrarchan format of the sonnets. And we know Petrarch was a poet who lived during the time of Boccaccio and at the same time of Chaucer. Chaucer was there in England and Boccaccio and Petrarch were in Italy. And it was Petrarch who introduced the sonnet form, constituted of an octave and a sestet. Octave is constituted of 8 lines and then the sestet, which contains 6 lines. And it was the Italian format of sonnet. And sonnet was constituted of 14 lines written in iambic pentameter. And Thomas White introduced the pattern in English literature. Thomas White was actually a British politician, a lyric poet, and he is mainly credited for introducing the Petrarchan format of the sonnets. And I told you, Thomas White had occasions to visit Italy and to see the Italian sonnet pattern, and he believed that it would save the English poetry from linguistic chaos. And he modeled his sonnets on Petrarch. And Thomas White, being a politician, had his patron, Thomas Cromwell. And it was Thomas Cromwell who took the responsibility of sending Thomas White to various countries. And when Thomas Cromwell was executed under orders of Henry VIII, Thomas White was forced to retain. And he was imprisoned in the jail in 1541. And very interestingly, Thomas White fell in love with Anne Bullion. And most of his poems are addressed to Anne. And when Anne Bullion was married to Henry VIII, he stopped the affair. And he entered into another affair with the cousin of Anne Boleyn named Mary Shelton. Wyatt had produced a few sonnets addressed to Shelton, and they are written in an acrostic format. In acrostic format, we come to find the first alphabet of the lines can be pronounced as a word, a meaningful word or a name. The first syllable or the last syllable of the lines can be pronounced as a word or a name. And a few poems written by Thomas Wyatt are considered as acrostic poems. And from the poems, we come to identify the name Shelton, S-H-E-L-T-U-N. And Thomas Wyatt got married with a lady named Elizabeth Brooke. And it was at the time, Henry VIII's wife, Catherine of Howard, was executed. And it was believed that Henry VIII had a plan of getting into an affair with Thomas Wyatt's wife. And he became very sorrowful on account of it. And he was caught by some disease and he died in 1542. And very interestingly, Thomas Wyatt was in love with Anne Boleyn. And when Anne Boleyn was put in the jail, Wyatt was also imprisoned there. And Wyatt had the occasion to see the execution of Anne Boleyn. Anne Boleyn was executed in 1536. On May 19, 1536. And five other men who are accused of having adultery with her were also executed on the same day. And Thomas Wyatt had occasion to watch the execution of Anne Boleyn through the window of his prison. And he was also there in the prison at the same time. But Thomas Wyatt was not executed. He was released from the jail and he continued to work as an ambassador under Henry VIII. And it was at the time Henry VIII got married with Catherine Howard, and she was also executed. And Thomas Wyatt was accused of having some relations with Catherine Howard also. And it was at the same time Thomas Cromwell was executed, and Thomas Cromwell was the patron of Thomas Wyatt, and Thomas Wyatt was also put in the jail, but again he was released from there. And Thomas Wyatt produced a number of sonnets, and most of his sonnets are addressed to a lady named Anna, an indirect reference to Anne Boleyn. And the major output of Thomas Wyatt is constituted of translations from Petrarch. Actually, he took the subject matter but changed the rhyme scheme. So, in Petrarch's sonnet, we come to find an octave and a sestet. But in Thomas Wyatt, we come to find the octave is there intact. There is no change. But the sestet is divided into a quatrain and a couplet. And this actually gave way to the format for the English sonnets developed by Henry Howard and William Shakespeare. And Thomas Wyatt was regarded by C.S. Lewis as the father of the drab age. Drab refers to dull or unornate. And in the opinion of C.S. Lewis, the poetry of Thomas Wyatt seemed to be very dull and unornate, and therefore he called him the father of the drab age. It was C.S. Lewis who considered the Elizabethan literature as the literature of the golden age, or the golden age of the 16th century. And in the golden age of the 16th century, there is also a drab age. And in the opinion of C.S. Lewis, it is the age of Thomas Wyatt. And he considered Thomas Wyatt as the father of the drab age. And very interestingly, there was another famous British literary critic named Patricia Thompson. And she describes Wyatt as the father of English poetry. And we come to find that during the time of Thomas Wyatt, his poems could not be published under his name. And a few of his poems were published and circulated at court anonymously. And they have been published in an anthology called The Court of Venus. And The Court of Venus was published in 1537. And a few poems of Thomas Wyatt were included in this collection called The Court of Venus. But they were put as anonymous poems. So the name of Thomas Wyatt was not included there. And the poems of Thomas Wyatt were published only after his death in a collection of poems published by Richard Tottle in the Tottle's Miscellany. And Tottle's Miscellany is also called Songs and Sonnets. And it was published in the year 1557. And it was Richard Tottle who published the poems of Henry Howard also in the same collection. And Henry Howard had produced a poem on the death of Thomas Wyatt. So it was entitled On the Death of Sir T.W. T.W. is Thomas Wyatt, the Elder. On the Death of Sir T.W. the Elder. And Thomas Wyatt maintained a good friendship with Henry Howard also. And Howard produced a poem on the death of Thomas Wyatt. And it was entitled On the Death of Sir T.W. the Elder. And these are the important things we learned from Thomas Wyatt. And thank you for the time being.